Lastly, I want to encourage you to think about the steel that you research categorically by the carbon content. Basically, if you take the carbon amount in a steel and you take the nitrogen amount and you add them together, you'll come up with roughly sort of what class of steel you're working with. Now, it might have different characteristics if it's had some very expensive manufacturing processes done to it or very good heat treatment, but you sort of have similar behaviors across steels that have the same carbon content. Chrome is a big variable, so more chrome will cause something that has the same carbon content to behave a little bit differently. But I just encourage you, learn what are your 0.6% steels, what are your 0.8s, what are your 1.0s, sort them into those categories, and then take note of the different characteristics. It'll really simplify you remembering this data in your head.